This video is about the constructor function in JavaScript. Now, this is a tricky and confusing topic. It relates to how you generate objects, and it's a different style than what I showed you in the previous video with a literal object being made into an array. And in fact, it's probably, and I hate to use this term, a slightly better style. It's a more flexible style. It will afford you some possibilities and get past some limitations that are here. So let's first talk about why do we need this other step before we even talk about what that other step is, the constructor function. So there's a couple reasons. So this example, first of all, it has an array, an empty array. In setup, it puts four objects into the array. There are those objects. And then in draw, it calls functions on those objects. Display the objects, move the objects. So where does this break down? There's a couple ways this breaks down. Number one is, it's a lot of code here in setup. This is a simple object. It just has an x, a y, and two functions. But you could imagine, you could have an object with 10 properties, 15 properties, 5 functions, 6 functions. You don't really want like all this code inside of this loop and setup. It's sort of hard to manage and keep track of. So number one, it'd be nice if we could move this somewhere else. It kind of, if you're thinking like, oh, I know, I could move it into another function. That's basically what we're going to do. We're going to move it into a special kind of function called a constructor function. The other reason why you might need a constructor function is you might want to make new objects in different places in your code. So you might want to start this program with 4 objects, and then every time you click the mouse, you get a new object. And so you need the literal object in setup when you make 4, and then you also need that in mouse press when you make another one. So you suddenly, this code, that the whole point of it was to not have to write it again because it's inside a loop. What if you need to do it later or somewhere else in the code? If you have the constructor function, that constructor function is reusable. So the purpose of the constructor function is a special function to make the object for you. So it's really like, this is making the object, but I want to put that somewhere else. Essentially what you're doing. So just reorganizing the code and some new possibilities will open up. So let's look at, before I even get to that, let's look at what that does to the code. So pretend that this, all this code didn't need to be here. And in fact, I'm going to like hit a lot of carriage returns, go far down here and leave it down here, and I'm going to comment it out so that it's not affecting anything. And I'm going to come back up here. And if I had a constructor function, I would be able to say something like this. New bubble. This is new syntax with the keyword new. What the keyword new it means is, hey, JavaScript, make a new object. What kind of object? This bubble object. How do I know what a bubble object is? I'm going to write a special function called bubble somewhere else that will explain what a bubble object is. Generate it, make it, put it here so that it goes into the array. So, and what's wonderful about this is this beautiful, lovely, clean, sort of like succinct syntax. Like all of the code for the object is now somewhere else. We can see that the main program is just, let's start with an empty array, let's put a bunch of things in it, and let's make those things move around the screen and do stuff. And so with this, all that's left to do is define what it is to be that bubble object, to write this constructor function that makes that bubble object. So how do you do that? That's the next piece. So I want to come over here to the whiteboard and, oops, hit my button again. Oh, come on, button. There I am. So I want to come over here and talk about that, the syntax for that. So what I think a good way of looking at it is, okay, so we know how to write a literal object. A literal object, I'm going to kind of squeeze over here to have some extra room. I'm just going to say var b. A literal object is a collection of name value pairs, properties. I have a property named x with a value of 100. I have a property named y with a value of 50. I have a property named display. And the value of this property, oh, it happens to be a function. And what do I do in that function? I draw an ellipse, I set a color. And if I want to refer back to a property of the object, remember I have to say this, another property, I have to say this.x. So this is the syntax that you're familiar with if you watch some of the previous videos. It's what I've used so far. So I'm going to draw a sort of magical line here. And what I want to do is look at this like a thing poking me. I don't have a lot. It looks like I'm in this big space here. Very cramped camera, light, thing poking me. Over here, what I want to do now is look at how do I make this with the constructor function? So the constructor function is a function just like any other function in JavaScript. So the syntax, in a weird sort of way, almost goes back to something that you might be a little more used to, but with some kind of strange other nuance and aspects to it. So to define a function in JavaScript, you simply write function, the name of that function, leave that blank for a second, if there are any arguments or parameters, parameters to that function, parentheses, an open curly bracket, can you see that? Yes, and a closed curly bracket. So a constructor function is a function just like any other function. However, we intend to use this function in a special case by invoking the new operator. So I want to say new bubble, meaning I want to execute a function called bubble with the new operator to make a new object. So a convention in how you name constructor functions is to name it with a capital letter. Okay, so this is a function named bubble. I've named it with a capital letter simply to note in my code that this is a special function. It's a constructor function. The thing that JavaScript is looking for is that new operator, the thing that I have over here. It's going to invoke that constructor function, say, hey, constructor function, make a new object. And just convention-wise, so I can keep track of what's doing what in my code, I'm going to capitalize that and name that with B, bubble capital B. I made this video earlier and had no sound in it, and I really explained that much better in the previous video that no one will ever see. I'm going to keep going. Something else I'm going to do in this video is going to be better, I'm sure. Okay, so now, once this function is triggered with the new operator, JavaScript says, okay, I'm going to make a new object. Now, the first thing we need to do is say what properties go into that new object. This is where the keyword this comes in again. If I say this.x equals 100, what I've done is the new bubble object that this constructor has made attach the property x to this bubble object. So in the same way that we added a property here saying x colon 100, the constructor function is making a new object and attaching x to that particular object, this object. So I can then also attach a y to it. And I can also, there goes the camera, I can also attach a function to it. And I know this, I'm gonna go off the screen here, but you, it's not a screen, this is a whiteboard, but let me actually write this a little smaller so you can see it. This.display equals function. So you can see now, technical fail, but I just gotta keep going here. This is already my second try. look, this is the thing that was poking me. Just turn that. okay, so you can see how this maps. This is making a literal object. Make this object be with an x, with a y, with a display. This is in a way like a template. It's saying the object doesn't exist yet, but if you were to call this function with a named bubble, then an object will be created with these properties. X will be attached to that object, y will be attached to that object, display will be attached to that object. So literal object, it exists. Template, idea of an object, way of generating the object. When you say new bubble, the object is made. And you might think that at the end here, you would want to say something like return this. So once the object is made, you want to then send it back to where you wanted it to make, right? Here I say, oh, I lost the camera. Oh God. I'm going to have to remake this video again tomorrow, which I might do. Here I said new bubble. I want this to evaluate to that new object. The new object here, the reference to that new object is the keyword this. But the thing about a constructor function is this is like what's, you don't have to say this. It's inherent to how once you invoke the new operator, that object will be returned. It's kind of unspoken. It's, you don't have to say it. It happens automatically for you. So this is the syntax. One of the things you might practice, right, an exercise that I'll give you at the end, is take something that you made in a literal object and try to convert it to this constructor function syntax. This is a really hard, confusing thing to explain and possibly understand. Hopefully I'm doing a slightly okay job. So let's do that now in the code itself. Remember down here before, I sort of left my code I had for the literal object commented out. So now I can actually write that constructor function. So I'm going to say function bubble. And now, what are the properties? I had an x and a y. So I need to say this.x equals random 0 to width. This.y equals random 0 to height. So you can see instead of the literal syntax, I'm actually setting properties attached to this equal to the values. It's sort of more like code being executed line by line. And then I can add the display function. And I can add the move function. And I left a space here. And then the nice thing is I can go and grab these lines. These haven't changed. Those functions are exactly the same. And I know I'm doing this kind of quickly, like if you're following along, you can pause the video and try to sort of do this yourself. I will upload these somewhere and try to put them in the description on YouTube or Vimeo or wherever you're watching this. But you can see now, let me put a little line break here. You can see now, this is the constructor function. This is a function whose sole purpose in life is to generate an object. When you say new bubble, that object is made, it's stored in the value this, X gets attached to it, Y gets attached to it, display gets attached to it, move gets attached to it. Unspoken at the end, that object, this object, is returned where? Where did I say new bubble? Up here. What do I do with it? I put it in the array. Boom. Boom. I don't know. It's a bubble. It pops. But so this function, new bubble. Now, notice, interestingly enough, you know, I hate to do this to you, but if I said this, this would not work, right? The constructor function is a function like any other. It will be executed, but all sorts of things will break and not work. This only works, JavaScript is looking for that keyword new in order to know to make this a new bubble object and attach the properties to it. So I put this in here, and I run it, and we've got four. And again, I've got this same magical thing. Now I'll make 400 bubbles, so I'm like running out of steam here. So hopefully this, so there's, you know, right now all I did in this particular example was take the literal object that I had in this loop up here and move it to a constructor function. So in the next video, what I would like to do is kind of show you what you could really do with this. Because now if I have this constructor function, I could say, when I click the mouse, also make a new bubble, and how do I add this to the array, right? So this is what we need to look at. I don't have to rewrite that. That constructor function can be reused anywhere in the code. So this won't work yet. This is the topic that I want to look at in the next video. And how do I maybe assign parameters to it, arguments to it? I want to make an object at this location, at mouse X, at mouse Y. So that's the topic I want to look at in the next video. For now, I would say if you want an exercise for yourself, go and find something, maybe watch the previous video and made a literal object in a loop. Take that literal object code out of the loop, write the constructor function, see if you can get to perform exactly the same way. Okay, so this is the end of this particular video. In the next one, I'll look at an array function called push and an array function called splice, which allows you to add things to an array and remove things from the array so we can have a much more flexible system. Okay, and I'm gonna hit stop now.